Hi everyone. I'm Jindong Han. Today I will present our work, Multi-Modal Transportation Recommendation with Unified Root Representation Learning. In this paper, we study the multimodal transportation recommendation problem. It aims to recommend a travel plan which considers various transport modes, such as walking, cycling, driving, and public transit. For example, the left figure shows a rail system has been deployed on Baidu map. And here, our system offers a route by jointly considering taxi and bus. However, this task is very difficult due to several reasons. First, we need to learn user preference from massive historical data. And then we need to capture the dynamic situational context. Finally, the combination of different transport modes is also very complex. Now we are going to solve this problem. We built our system based on three motivations. First, the transportation network is very large and highly dynamic. For example, the transportation network of Beijing has lots of route segments, and its traffic conditions are changing over time. So how can we model the dynamic spatio-temporal dependencies in transportation network? That's the first challenge. Second, we also identify another important dependency in travel route. We call it route coherence. That is to say, if we regard a route as a sentence, then each vertex of the route corresponds to a word. So the representation of each vertex are semantically consistent with the whole route. So how to capture intro route semantic dependencies is a question. Besides, the route sequence is of arbitrary length, and the importance of each vertex may vary. So how to learn fixed length route representation vectors is another challenge. Finally, a route in the multimodal transportation network may be shared by several transport modes. For example, given a bicycle route, it is with a high probability we can also travel this route by walk. So how to distinguish the unified representation for various transport modes is also a problem. To solve this problem, we design a hierarchical multitask route representation learning framework. This figure shows an overview of our approach. The inputs are the multimodal transportation network, historical routes, and context features such as weather conditions. The output is the recommended route. Overall, there are three tasks in our method. We first construct a multi-view transportation graphs. Then the unified route representation learning and the hierarchical multitask learning are used for recommendation. In the first task, we transform the multimodal transportation network to a set of time-evolving graphs from two perspectives, the hub-centric view and the link-centric view. To be specific, a hub is an intersection or a bus station. And in the link-centric graph, each vertex denotes a road segment or a bus line. In the second task, we aim to learn unified route representation. As we know, hubs and links are correlated with its neighbors. So we apply graph neural network to capture spatial autocorrelations. And for temporal correlation, we also use a recurrent neural network to model the relationships between different time periods. Then we use bidirectional recurrent neural network and triplet loss to capture root coherence. The main idea of root coherence modeling is increasing the similarity between different halves and links in the same root. So we can model the relationships between current vertex and its prefix or suffix subroots. Additionally, in order to transform arbitrary length roots into fixed length representation vectors, we also use self-attention mechanism to automatically learn the importance of each hub and link in the same root. In the third task, we differentiate representations of various transport modes through multiple tasks. Besides, incorporating multiple related auxiliary tasks can also improve the recommendation performance. Specifically, we employ the hard parameter sharing, and the learning tasks can be categorized into two classes. Vertex level tasks and root level tasks. For vertex level tasks, we introduce distance prediction, ETA forecasting, and node type inference. For root level tasks, we extract root distance, ETA, and transport mode as supervision signals. Finally, we jointly optimize both main recommendation task and auxiliary tasks. What kind of data we are using? We use four types of data. First, the transportation network data. Second, the routing query data, which can be extracted from user logs. Third is historical trajectory data. In addition, we also use context data to enhance the recommendation. This table shows the overall performance of our method and all the compared baselines on Beijing and Shanghai datasets. We can see our model outperforms all the baselines on both datasets using all metrics, which demonstrates the effectiveness of our method. We also conduct ablation study on our model. We can see if we remove each component of our model, then the recommendation performance drops rapidly. So all the proposed components in our model have our recommendation task. And we also observe multi-view graphs help the most. Finally, we also show model performance in different routing query subgroups. We group queries by different OD pair distance, time period, and transport mode. As can be seen in the first picture, our model performs better on long distance recommendations. In the second picture, we also observe an accurate recommendation at night and a worse result in morning rush hour. In the third picture, the performance of mixed transport mode is notably lower than others. So in the future, we can pay more attention to mixed routes to obtain a better overall performance. So that's all. Thank you.